Hi, and welcome to another Vectornator Academy tutorial. In this video, we'll focus on the shape tool. You can use this tool to add various shapes to your design, from simple ones like rectangles, circles, or lines, to the more complex shapes like spirals or stars. So let's start with the basics, shall we? First up is the rectangle tool. You can see straight off the bat that there's a slider here, which helps you define the corner radius. The smaller this value, the sharper the corners. So if I select one, I am creating a pretty standard rectangle, nothing too crazy. And if I want to create a square instead, I just place one finger on the canvas and hold, and that will automatically preserve the aspect ratio. I have the option to fill in these shapes, and all I need to do is go to Style tab and tap on the Fill and Stroke switch here. Even after you've created your shape, you can still change the corner radius by going to the Quick Actions menu and adjusting as you see fit. But of course, if I go back to the Shape tool itself, I can set the corner radius prior to creating my shape by adjusting the slider. If you tap on the slider, you can enter a specific number manually if you know the precise measurements of your radius. And when I create this square here, it's going to have the specific radius that I pre-selected, which is 20 points in my case. You can see it in the Quick Actions again, but also in the Style tab. So we've got three different ways to perform this action. Use whichever fits your workflow the best. The cool thing about this, when the radius corner is at a maximum, we are left with a circle. Okay, moving on. The next in line is the Polygon tool. The Polygon slider is a bit different. It allows you to choose the number of sides of your shape, which can go from a minimum of 3, a triangle, to a maximum of 20, which is called an icosagon, if you're curious. If we choose a shape with an even number of sides, like a hexagon, then the shape will start forming from the middle as you drag your pencil out. And even after the shape is drawn, you're able to change the number of the sides from the Quick Actions menu by simply dragging on this slider. But when you're working with a polygon with an uneven number of sides, like a pentagon, when you drag to draw, you will notice that the direction of the point will change accordingly. If you drag up, the point of the pentagon will point up, and vice versa. Let's move on to the third shape on the list, which is the ellipse. No slider, which already tells us this is going to be pretty straightforward. Simply drag to create your shape, tap and hold a finger anywhere on the canvas to make circles. So let's go to the star shape, which has a bit more complexity to it. We've got a slider again, which allows you to choose the number of points of your star from the minimum of 3 to a maximum of 50. Let me choose something simple, like the classic 5-point star. Drag and drop, and now we have a beautiful star. Same as with the polygon tool, the way you drag your pencil will affect your shape. If you drag up, the star will point up, and if you drag down, the point will form down. A cool tip when creating stars is holding one finger on the canvas, which will then help you change the star's shape. So you can make it rounder or sharper, depending on the effect you want to achieve. Finally, you can change the number of points of your star straight from the Quick Actions menu again. And that's all there is to say about stars. So let's move on to the line tool, which also falls into the straightforward category, literally. Since it's basically a stroke, I'm just going to switch from fill to stroke in the Style tab really quick. Tap and hold, and your line appears. Holding one finger on the canvas will be super helpful here as well. This will enable your line to snap at 45-degree increments, meaning that it can snap horizontally, diagonally, or vertically as you move the line up or down. This is a great way to keep your lines sharp and aligned properly. Okay, the last shape on our list is the spiral. You guys must be familiar with the slider by now. In this case, it will determine the decay of the spiral, or in simpler terms, how tight or loose the spiral is going to look. A big decay will render this type of spiral. And moving the pencil around the canvas will then reflect on how the resulting spiral will be created. However, if we choose a small decay, the spiral will look more like a wave, like so. One of my favorite ways to make use of this shape is to actually fill it in by going to the Style tab, so now it looks more like a shell. To wrap this up, as with any of the shapes we just described, you can rotate them by dragging on this orange point here, and you can always alter the stroke from the quick actions. Shapes seems like a simple topic, but there are a lot of ins and outs to learn. Hope this video was helpful for you guys. See you in our next lesson. Bye!